Antonio Conte, I'm watching you. I'm watching you very, very closely. I'm watching you. All of us, all Interisti are watching you. Allah, Jesus, Shiva, Krishna, all them men are watching you very, very closely. I dare you, I double dare you to fail once again to take Inter to the next stage of the Champions League group stage. I dare you to fail again in Europe as usual.
And I dare you, I double dare you, motherfuckers.
Yes, guys, here we are to preview Inter's biggest match of the season yet. There's no other way to put it. Inter versus Real Madrid Champions League group stage match. The return leg from the previous match where Inter lost 3-2. And it's a must-win match, as Antonio Conte said himself in the pre-match press conference. He said all the right things. I was listening and I was much more impressed. This feels like more the real Antonio Conte. I said in the post-match Torino press conference, he was a lot more, you know, feisty, a lot more, you know, biting back at the press, but also criticizing his players for not being good enough. And once again today he said, you know, there's no excuses, we have to win, we need at least 7 points to progress to the next stage, which is true. You need the Champions League group stages, 9 points pretty much guarantees you progression to the next stage. He admitted this is basically like a final, like Zidane said in the last match against Inter, for them is like a final, but for Inter it really is. Both teams are not in the ideal situation in the group. It was a you know, not even the Shakhtar fans would have predicted the situation that's currently in the group, with the Mönchengladbach and Shakhtar being top of the group and Real Madrid on 4 points and Inter on 2 points at the bottom. Embarrassing. But a win can literally turn everything around. One win, 3 points, Inter go back to 5 points in the group. Real Madrid will go bottom. The balance of this group really is hanging by a thread. And anything can happen tomorrow night, 8 p.m. UK time kickoff at the San Siro. Once again, both teams struggling with injuries and COVID issues. Real Madrid have their captain and talisman and, you know, the most important player, Sergio Ramos, out with an injury. Valverde, Federico Valverde, who was, you know, very impressive against Inter, he's out. He's like the engine, physical, box-to-box, so he'll be a very big miss for them. Odriozola is out, Jovic is out with COVID. Karim Benzema is also a very big doubt, very unlikely to start. He didn't start the weekend against Villarreal. So all in all, you know, it's a very much weakened team. Although Carvajal now is back at the right back spot, so they have a proper right back, not Vasquez like last time. On the Inter side of things, obviously Brozovic is still out with the COVID. Kolarov is also still out. Sensi, of course, we can't count on him yet. We'll see in the next coming weeks whether he's able to finally come back. Here are the predicted lineups from Who Scored, which are not very accurate actually. You can see the back line should actually be the you know, the best Inter lineup that we have, with the Bastoni, De Vrij and Skriniar, not D'Ambrosio as they put there. But everything else is pretty much spot on. We know Eriksen is not going to start, even though Brozovic is out, even though Gagliardini is not really a centre defensive mid, he's not, you know, he's not Regista, but we don't really have an alternative. I am not a fan of Gagliardini in big matches. We saw against Sevilla in the Europa League final, you know, he just, when the matches are high level in terms of technicality and, you know, pace of the match, Gagliardini just struggles. He's a complete fish out of water. He's fine against, you know, smaller teams in Serie A, like the likes of Genoa, Sampdoria, teams like this where, you know, the match is a bit more physical, a bit slower, but the pace is slower. But when the level needs to be raised, Gagliardini, I do not like him. And I can't blame him, you know, that's the limits of his ability. Antonio Conte believes he's the only midfielder in the squad who has natural defensive capabilities, you know, due to his physicality, and he's not very attacking. He's a bit more disciplined compared to all of our other midfielders, which is kind of true. That's why he wants to get a defensive midfielder in January, and that's why he was pushing so much to try to get N'Golo Kante. I am hoping to see the 3-5-2 again, or the 3-5-2 hybrid that we saw against Shakhtar and against Real Madrid in the last match. So when we're defending, to have Gagliardini being, you know, sitting, so we have a bit more solidity there. There's a body in there to look after whoever's going to be roaming in that half space for Real Madrid. And then when we're attacking, we'll probably go back to the 3-4-1-2 with either Barella or Vidal taking up the role of CAM, which actually I think both of them can do it turn by turn. I don't think it has to be one of them. I think both of them can each maybe take a turn to, you know, see if the other guy goes forward, one stays back. Because Vidal is much better than Barella in terms of his movement off the ball and getting into the box, but Barella's better at carrying the ball into the box and being a bit more of a threat going into the box with the ball at his feet. Obviously, a lot of eyes once again will be on Ashraf Hakimi, the youngster last match. He definitely did not go well for him against his old club. It seemed like he was almost targeted. There was that bit interchange with him and Ramos when he was on the floor where he was telling him to get up, calling him a little rat. So hopefully Hakimi comes back with, you know, the bit between his teeth, with a bit of anger, with a bit of personality to show, you know, what he's really made of. You know, I don't want to see no Damian side on that right hand side. That needs to be Hakimi's spot. I want to see what he's made of. The left hand side, it should be Ashley Young, even though he did struggle against Torino, but he's, you know, he's a bit more defensive. He's definitely more of a wing back than Perisic, so hopefully he does start. And obviously up front has to be Lautaro and Lukaku. Lautaro got a little bit of a rest against Torino, even though he had to come on, still got a goal. He's in a decent vein of form. He scored against Madrid last time as well, had a good match. Lukaku, who we missed so much last time against Madrid, he's back. He's still in great form, still carrying Inter on his back. And hopefully we see more of that tomorrow. For Madrid, even though who scored here puts Benzema at the top, it will be probably Mariano Diaz up front, who is definitely not their preferred choice. But, you know, he'll do a job as a more out-and-out striker, unless they go for more like a false nine option. And also there, who scored have put in Odegaard, but it would be probably Casemiro, who has recovered. He should be back from what I read into the starting lineup, so it'll be more of a 4-3-3 formation, with Hazard obviously coming, drifting in from the left hand side, and Vasquez being more of a winger. At the back, as I said, obviously Ramos is a big miss, but even with Ramos, this Real Madrid team do not look great defensively. The things that give me confidence going into this match is that last match, and I rewatched that Madrid match, that pretty much almost every time Inter attacked, we got into their defense quite easily. Like, their defense was very shaky. In general, you know, this season, Zidane's team have not looked good at all, keeping teams out. So that does give me a lot of confidence, especially without Ramos, with Militao or Nacho next to Varane, who Varane has had a dip in performance this season as well. I am confident that we can definitely score some goals. As people have been pointing out, and Conte was asked in the press conference why Inter have been slow starters this year. If you've noticed, last year it was the opposite. We would come into match like madmen, first 30-40 minutes would, you know, score one or two goals. Especially Lautaro was known to score a lot of goals last season in the first 20-30 minutes. But this year it's the other way around. We seem to start really sluggishly and, you know, kind of have a little bit of a show, a bit of personality towards the end. But in this match, we can't gift a half to Real Madrid like we did last time. We gifted them two goals with the Hakimi back pass for Benzema's first goal. And then leaving Ramos, it still angers me how we just left him for the 2-0 goal on the header from the corner. And then obviously at the end, the energies weren't managed well by Conte. Vidal was like, you know, dying out there, and he was the one that probably should have covered Rodrigo, who scored the final winning goal. So it's important, Conte, this time round, you know, Barella and Vidal both played 90 minutes against Torino. They both, you know, ran a lot. He manages the energies properly. If Vidal, you know, around the 50th or 60th minute, you can see that he's starting to get tired. He's played every single minute for Chile as well in the international break. Take him out. Nainggolan has shown that he can come in. If he really doesn't trust Christian Eriksen that much, you know, let Nainggolan have some minutes. Otherwise, bring in Alexis Sanchez in that CAM position. And he admitted again, Conte, today that, you know, we're not going to see Sanchez in the CAM position from the beginning because he feels that's too attacking. But in the match, whilst the match is playing, I think that's a great option to have, especially if we are drawing. Oh, we need a goal. Sanchez has to come on. He needs to get 20-30 minutes towards the end, because this is a must-win match. A draw doesn't help us. A loss definitely puts us out of the Champions League. So a must-win match, and I don't want to see Conte being, you know, careful or slow with his changes as he often has. This is a make-or-break game. In terms of match prediction, you know, the positivity, the Interista inside of me, you know, that's telling me that, you know, we can get a result, we can beat this depleted Real Madrid team. We're missing the two most important players. But when you look back at our performances in the Champions League and in big matches over the last few years, it just doesn't bode well. Sevilla, obviously, last year. Barcelona, when they played the B team against us last year in the group stage when we needed to win. PSV the year before, and the Spalletti, you know, these crunch matches we just fail to turn up. Dortmund last year as well. But when I think about it logically, with the players missing, the Inter being top scorers in the league, scoring goals freely, I feel like we really will score goals against this Real Madrid team, and we can get a 2-1 victory. But the realist in me, seeing Inter's performances over the last few years, my realistic score prediction is a 2-2 draw. You know, a draw that doesn't help either team really, but it definitely does not help Inter, and it makes the last two matches a must win. But yeah, hoping to see you guys for the post-match reaction of that, which hopefully, Conte, I said, I'm watching you. There will be a positive reaction. Let me know your thoughts and predictions below. Who would you start? Would you even risk Eriksen starting? Would you even give Nainggolan a chance? Would you do Perisic or Young on the left-hand side? Damian or Hakimi? Sanchez, Lautaro, Lukaku, what do you think? Let me know in the comments below. Make sure to leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you for the post-match. Ciao ragazzi and Forza Inter!